The genetic makeup of colorectal cancer is becoming increasingly important in its management. The genetic makeup of a tumor helps us to be able to think about therapies that may be appropriate for individual patients or for groups of patients that have a particular expression pattern. So the genetic makeup may tell us what therapies are likely to work. It may give us some clues as to the aggressiveness of the tumor, and it may also provide insights that we currently don't have, but that for future use in terms of selecting novel therapies based on expression patterns that we can characterize from assessing a tumor. In evaluating a tumor, it begins with the simple process of acquiring a sample of the malignant component and looking at what that particular tumor is expressing that may help us understand whether or not the disease process is likely to behave unfavorably, or perhaps in some cases we can determine that it's perhaps not as bad or not as aggressive as we might think. These characterizations oftentimes are therefore carried out on that which is removed from the body during an operative intervention for, say, a colorectal cancer. We understand that in the setting where lymph nodes are not involved, that we think that patients typically will do better with observation. We now are learning that, and we've always known that there are groups of patients who did not have lymph nodes involved that were at higher risk of recurrence, and it seemed to mirror the risk of recurrence of those patients who did have lymph nodes involved. So in other words, when we find that the disease has gotten out of the room and is actually now going down the hallway, we knew that there was a higher risk of recurrence or a higher risk of something showing up in another corridor. But what was more challenging to understand are for those patients where there wasn't any spots or people running down the hallway, but yet they seem to have a higher risk of recurrence. It's in this setting that we apply a molecular profile. A molecular profile is simply characterizing the genetic expression pattern within that tumor tissue. So on the outward appearance, perhaps this tumor looks like any other tumor that does not involve lymph nodes, for instance. But by applying the molecular signature, we get a sense that there are groups of patients that do not have the clinical phenotype of a bad tumor or a tumor that's likely to have a higher risk of recurrence. But by looking at its expression pattern, we can identify components that may result in a higher risk, and therefore thinking about offering this group of patients treatment.
For an interactive tool to learn more about your colon cancer and your personalized treatment options, go to mycoloncancercoach.org.